it is prey.
Did you guys know that the same person who was speaking for Gollum was also speaking for the Witch King and this circus? Yes, indeed. Today we are going to play Mordor against Hard Army on a beautiful map West Emnet in Battle for Middle-earth 1 on the patch 2.22 in the Dwarven mod. Grassy lands of Rohan lying between the Entwash and the Isen River. Let's get it started. Thank you so much for the follow on the Twitch channel, and look at this, look at our orcs, guys. They are looking pretty dope to me. Orc pit is pretty much unchanged, the same money, right? Yes, the same money also for the orc pit, and we will use those starting units to capture those settlements. However, that's not a great spot here for the lumber mill because, you know, there are no trees around. So ideally, when you want to build lumber mills, that's not the best spot. You want to build that on spots in which you can actually, you know, like Fangorn Forest, for example, with a bunch of trees around. This way your workers, they don't need to walk too much to collect the resources, but it's fine. The orc pits and orcs are still for free. And look how many units we will get the chance to recruit later on. That's pretty dope. And I would also like, Gollum, please, can you move to the spot and so we can capture this? Actually, every single settlement from these three are actually quite horrible for the Mordor faction or for the Isengard faction because there are almost no trees around. But I would, you know, look at this beautiful man. This design of the orcs is something different. And again, guys, that's a mod from 2013. And impressive job by whoever made this mod. You will need some more workers very, very soon. Because more workers mean more money. That doesn't mean that you need to spam them. I mean, ideally, you want to have around 6 workers. That's a great number. Depends also on, of course, the layout of the map. When there are too many trees around, it's also good when you get like 8 workers in total for a lumber mill. But other than that, 6 is a pretty nice number. Remember, lumber mills are unique to the evil factions like Mordor and Isengard. And they are also the best money and resource generating resource buildings in the entire game. So we need to vault check. Let me see. Looks like we are against a good faction player. And we also need to make sure to kind of pressure him. However, on this map, West Emnet, we have 2 troll layers in the middle, protecting those 2 settlements, left and right. And Mordor, you know what? We can also build the second orc pit just to be a little bit annoying, you know? We can spam lots of units on the field all the time. However, we can't creep with the, you know, orcs early on. That's not possible. To creep a work layer, you will need at least, at bare minimum, 3 orcs. We are against Rohan. I see Rohan peasants, and we are rushing through the middle. As for the resource buildings, I would still like to build the slaughterhouses, and we will take a look into every single unit later on. But as you guys know me, I would like to take a look early on, first of all, into the heroes to see the differences. So Gollum, we will of course lose this fight, but it is how it is. Maybe we can use Eye of Sauron here. The power points, the beginning ones, are pretty identical. It also gives you the same boost, 100% more combat experience and 50% more damage. Let's use Eye of Sauron right off the bat. He's getting more and more peasants on the field in the meantime, but that's fine. We are getting also more orcs in the meantime. Again, Mordor is a faction which gets power points as he's losing orcs, which is the reason why we have now 2 orc pits. This way we can spam orcs all the time. And it doesn't hurt us, you know, if we lose them because we don't invest anything but command points. And command points in this mod, let's be real, are no problemo, because we have 800 command points available. Holy guacamole, guys. Like, just for you to understand, the orcs, they cost you only 10 command points in this mod. So for 800, we can actually recruit 80 battalions of orcs. I mean, Gothmog was literally right. The age of men is over. Like, literally is over. He has Rohirrim archers already, and also a tower. This guy is rich. I mean, we are also rich, actually, at least in this game, not in real life, of course, but it's okay. Money changes people, that's what they told me. That's also an excuse of poor people, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to be rich, because money changes people. I've never heard a rich guy saying that kind of stuff, by the way. Alright, let's do that. The farm is gonna be taken down, that's great. We have also a lot of money. So what we wanna do now, after that, is we wanna creep a Borg layer or a Goblin layer first, because we would, I would love to capture another outpost. Maybe this one. And for the heroes, because now we have cheap heroes. We have Gorbeck and also Shagrad. For 800 and for 600 only. So actually pretty cost efficient heroes. And we have the Nazguls for 1800. and the Witch King of Angmar himself for 2600 only. So actually the heroes here are quite cost efficient. Because we are putting so much pressure. Oh, Gollum! Look, how can you kill this cutie, man? Come on now. What can you do? I remember this guy. Do you guys remember this guy? He was also, you know, in Sirith Ungol, you know? In the lair of Shelob. He was the one who was actually, you know, kind of saving Frodo Baggins. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Kick. Knocks down and damages the target hero. That's nice. But the ability's name, just like Kick. Greed. Garbag's attack decreases production of enemy resource structures. That's very interesting. Crude cunning become invisible with level 4. And last but not least, forest labor increase the resource output or production rate of the target structure for 30 seconds. Pretty good, pretty good. So I'm not expecting him to be very strong because it's extremely cost efficient. But, you know, it's better than nothing. So we have more and more units on the field in the meantime. We can also try to creep this one eventually. I want to focus down the lair first. We can even buy the outpost here. Please buy it. There we go. For 600 only. Pretty much just like in the, you know, normal BFME one. Nothing has changed about the price. And also the outpost is looking just like the same one we are used to see. Beside the Erebor faction, of course, they also improved the other factions. Changed the other factions. I believe that's the right word. What is that? Loyalty to the Eye. Chagrat gains 20% armor and damage when near Mordor structures. We've also Captain of the Tower. 50% more damage, 50% experience for nearby Black Uruks. And last but not least, we have Get Them Lads. Summons 2 units of Black Uruks to Chagrat's side. Talking about Black Uruks, I believe you are able to recruit them from a level 2 Orc Pit. They will cost 250 each, so they are not cheap by all means. Will we be able to creep this? The answer is yes, ladies and gentlemen. We will be able to creep this indeed. Now, we have the chance to recruit a Nazgul. I'm actually pretty curious if we can use the trolls to creep a... You know, use the heroes to creep a troll. That's what I was trying to say. Speaking in English is hard sometimes. Sorry for that. So, we have lots of orcs on the field. We can, you know, just send them forward. Once again, losing them doesn't hurt at all. We can also pick up the Tainted Land, which also seems to be the same. Then we have also Sorcery of Dol Guldur. Invokes the Sorcery of Dol Guldur to summon a castellan and chaos enemies to flee from the casting location. Okay. So, I wanna see if we can creep the Troller in the middle of the map. Let's find out. If not, we will have also 2 Nazguls joining the battlefield very, very, very soon. Talking about the Nazgul, that's how it's looking like. You can also get mounted. They are like Black Riders. Unlike in the normal battle for Middle of One, here they are not able... Look, this guy is attacking like in slow motion. Chagrat, come on now. And they are also dealing almost no damage, the heroes. Once again, the Trolls in BFME 1, guys, they are beefy. They don't die that fast. We have Screech. We have also 9 Servants of Sauron. As more Nazgul gather, their strength grows. We have Haste of the 9. Increase the... Oh, be careful. Imagine the troll is crushing everything. Chagrat. But the Nazgul has taken him down. So let's creep this ASAP. What is that? That's an increase. Lieutenant of Morgul. That's like a, you know, affects Morgul, Orcs and Heroes. Leadership for a nearby unit. And also the Black Breath. Gives... -35% armor and -50% damage to nearby enemies. So it's like a debuff kind of thing. Also talking about the Witch King, of course, I mean Nazgûs, we will also need to recruit their leader, who is the Witch King himself. Here, let's build another Lumber Mill, and eventually we will try to creep this. However, trolls, once again, are beefy. I want to build a Haradrim Palace here, just to see the difference, because we have not a single new building inside this faction. Okay. Slowly but surely, reclaiming the map. And let's build one more Orc Pit. Just why not? Okay, actually the Nazguls are not bad at all. Like, they are quite tanky. I'm surprised. I'm wondering about the tankiness of the Witch King himself. Let's put pressure all the time. Okay, what is that? Slave Fields of Nurn. Orc Pits, Troll Cages, Siege Wars, Movement Kill Pens, and Haradrim Palaces slowly produce resources. And also the Dark Tower. I would like to see that. The thing is, what this mod did, was actually kinda nerfing. Hold on a second. Okay, we are winning this battle, no problemo. Okay, the black, oh my goodness, what is that? Most heroes do 50% damage, 100% more damage, 200% more combat experience, and 100% fear resistant. That's dope. Open in the name of Mordor. Does 1500 damage to a target kit. Reduces armor by 50 for 2 minutes. Toggle weapon with level 6, must be on foot to use. We have also Morgul Blade, damages a hero attributes until his death, must be wielding a sword to use. And last but not least, the Witch King's Hour with level 10 globally lowers enemy heroes by attack by 50% and increases power recharge times by 500%. Attacks deal additional damage, lasts for 60 seconds. Holy guacamole. I will break him. Feast on his flesh. Can you get mounted? No, we have actually two heroes on foot and three heroes mounted on horse. However, this Mordor, unlike the Mordor we are used to, has no flying heroes. Haradrim Palace. Oh, yeah. We have actually... What is that? Variax of Kant and Soldiers of Rune. And last but not least, Archers of Rune. Okay, we have now every hero on the field. They have no chance. He has captured the outpost, but that's fine. Let's crush it. We have also 3 power points collected, which we could not use just yet. Scavenger costs 4, and this costs 5 or 4. A Cold Heart. Darkness is pretty much identical, and also the Dark Tower. That's what I want to see the most. Okay, let's creep this right off the bat, actually with the... Oh, this farm is kind of tanky, or the damage output of the heroes is kind of low. I'm a bit disappointed that this Nazgul or the Witch King looks exactly the same. The same model has been used for the Witch King. There is zero difference in terms of design of the unit. So just visually, you cannot tell who is the Witch King and who is the normal Nazgul. And I don't like that, to be honest. I believe Witch King should always look a little bit different. I'm also disappointed in normal battle for Middle-earth 1 that the Witch King doesn't look too different from the Nazguls, because he's the Witch King at the end of the day. Okay. What are these? These are Haradrim. Haradrim. Spearmen, right? I mean, no, the normal Haradrims. Haradrim Skirmishers. Very interesting. We need to get it to level 3 as soon as possible, as I would like to see the other units. And also, I'm curious if they also added Grond to the Mordor faction as a siege weapon. Again, we have now so much money, we can do whatever we want. And in order to increase the money income even more, let's pick up the Scavenger from the Spellbook. And look at that. In normal game, if you have this many orcs on a field, there is no way or no world in which you wouldn't be command points capped. But this is not one of these mods, guys. You can also buy banner and fire everything from this. Let's recruit normal units also, because the Orc Pit is now level 2. We need it to be level 3, if I'm not mistaken. Requires the Dark Tower to be built. Dark Tower has to be built up. This one. For you to get the chance to recruit the Archers of Morgul. And also Orcs of Morgul. Okay, anyways, let's build the Troll Cage, the Mumma Kilpan, and also the Siege Works. Now, all of a sudden, we have not that much money anymore, but it's fine. It's fine. We have literally the full map control. I believe we kind of broke Rohan's economy, right? Is it hard army? Yeah, it's hard army. I'm actually surprised about the performance of this hard army. They normally pop off, but not this day. Okay, let's capture this one. We have literally full map control. I want to see what he's actually doing. You know what? We can send a squad of orcs, just a little bit of them. He was closing the gate. His towers around 1, 2, 3, 4 towers he has around. So it's a great amount of defense. And also, thank you so much for the follow, Tisiri Casp. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. Means a lot. All right, more resource buildings. This is level 2 yet. What is that? Poisoned arrowheads upgrade. Deals 25 damage over 5 seconds and slow non-hero units. Purchase upgrade at the structure. I believe you can upgrade the Haradrim Skirmishers, which are different. Let's get these units on the field and also send them forward. This guy is kind of prisoning himself. Oh my goodness. I believe he doesn't know how to open the gate or something. Ah, yeah, because there is a thing that postern gate is not possible, right? Yeah, he's kind of doomed. Remember when I was playing, guys, Rohan the other day? You can't build postern gate. I believe the AI is too dumb to understand that. And he's desperately trying to leave his castle, but he prisoned himself. No way, what is this army? I'm scared. I'm actually really scared. Okay, as for the siege weapons, it looks identical, right? There is no differential at all. Troll cage is also looking pretty much the same. And Mooma kill pan is also looking the same. However, this Mooma kills, you are only limited to have 3 of them at the same time, and they are expensive as hell. They cost nearly 2,000. And remember, they would even cost more if you have 0 slaughterhouses. They get cheaper the more slaughterhouses you have. Slaughterhouse gives you food bonus. Food bonus makes your monsters cheaper. Okay, so I want to see what this... Hold on a second. We have also orc archers on the field. Let's get every upgrade. Before we break, because that's going to be an epic battle, right? I want to be ready, you know? It's like a, you know, build-up game at this point. It's kind of meh. I wish we would be against the evil faction, which has no gates, because this guy obviously doesn't know that postern gate isn't possible in this mod, for whatever reason. Okay, he was capturing this. These are the elite unit, sprint with level 2. Can we get it to level 3 though? Yeah, it's level 3 now. But again, requires a dark tower to be built. So many of these stuff is only possible if you have the dark tower. And we still need a lot for that. So we need 3 more for the darkness and then actually 18 more for the dark tower. So hopefully this is going to be something busted. And also trolls have like a circle around them, as you can see and tell. They have the same abilities. Mooma kill looks pretty much the same. I don't know how strong they are in terms of cooling, how tanky they are, how much damage they deal. I can't tell and confirm. Oh! Okay, he was actually able all of a sudden to open his gate. Okay, now that changes something, of course. Yeah. Do we have normal Haradrims? Hold on a second. We need to capture this ASAP. And put one of these units inside the citadel. And you, my friend, go, 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 go. You go here, because this way we have some sort of protection. Okay, we need our heroes here as soon as possible. And we have also lots of orcs. These are black Uruks of Mordor. They have also, they are also looking like Uruks. Block formation, just like the Urukai. And superior training. Increased health. Purchase upgrade at Orc Pit to enable this upgrade. Okay, say no more. I believe this is this one, yeah. I believe that's gonna make them a bit more tanky. So they are like the elite swordmen from Mordor, which is something Mordor doesn't normally has. Mordor kinda breaks the rule of quality goes over quantity, at least in battle from... Oh my goodness. Okay, I mean, the Rams are going now to war. So let's pick up the darkness and let's use it right off the bat. Because it will give us more damage, but the tower has been taken down. He has so many Rohirrim archers on the field. Holy crap, come on. Okay, I mean, the thing is that trolls are here, no problemo, they got us, you know? They got our back. So what I want to do, as you guys know me, I want to go like crazy. I would like to make a huge army of these Haradrim skirmishers and put them on top of the Mumakil. However, we are kind of short on the money department as we are investing so much into these Mumakils. Okay, we are getting more and more power points, that's great. We lost one of the outposts, but it's kind of fine-ish, I guess. Let's defend this with the heroes, and now let's go to this side. I will break him. I want to desperately get... Oh, we will also lose this outpost, by the way. Does he have heroes on the field? No, he has only normal Rohirrim. He has a ram, that's why he's dealing crazy amount of damage to our outpost. Okay. Let's just, you know, the day of the orc, just focus him, the Uruks. The black Uruks of Mordor. I'm assuming they are... Oh, you know, they look pretty much like Uruks, also the designing of the unit, right? Yeah, almost like, a little bit different, but they're also still getting one-shotted almost from the trample. Never mind, they're actually tankier than orcs. Hold on, turn and fight maybe? Okay, we gotta peel back. Okay, we were able to survive level 5 unlock. Where is Witch King? Witch King? Go, go, Witch King, go, go, Witch King. Let's use Tainted Land. Doesn't do anything, but it looks cool. Alright, so orcs. We need more orcs, guys. We got, again, as we lose them, we also get more and more power points collected. And with the push, he was able to reclaim lots of the map control, but it's also kind of fine. It's kind of good for us because we will this way be able to... Hold on a second. To get more and more power points collected as we are killing more stuff. Get him, lads. Summons two battalions. Let's summon with Shagrad. They are not permanent. They are only for a short duration. Are they not able to shoot? You cannot target with the Mordor units on top of the Citadel. Okay, that's what it is. Okay. Oh, Korbek got killed. The Nazgûs are dying also one by one. They are just getting kind of crushed. Level 8 is needed for that, the Black Breath. So let's deal. Let's not lose them, actually. The Witch King can still do some work. He's quite healthy. Let's reclaim this outpost in the meantime. And we are almost there, ladies and gentlemen, for the Dark Tower power point from the Spellbook of Mordor for 12 power points. And also, please let me know in the comment section down below what do you guys think about this mod so far, about the changes they have implemented into the existing factions like Mordor and Rohan. And of course, we can also take a look into the Gondor and Isengard in the following days. I personally enjoy that so far. I want to see how strong this combination of movement kills with this better Haradrim's is going to be. If this is going to be way, way stronger, I can tell and confirm. So we will take a look into that once again together. Okay. We were able to win this fight. These Uruks, they're going to be gone very soonish. Let's build... Actually, hold on a second. I would also like to recruit Drummer Troll. We will need two more Trolls for that. Okay, let's build more Furnaces here. Even though we will lose this eventually very, very soon, but it's okay. I mean, it will keep the opponents around this side. You know, losing offensive structures is always not the worst case scenario because that will kind of keep the opponent busy at their side of the map. I will break him. Go, Witch King. Break them all. Level 7. I want to see that, actually. The Witch King's hour. I would love to see that. Maybe he's going to say, it is my hour. Look, he's using Screech. I didn't even press anything. Like, he was using it. Oh, now he looks different. Right? Now he looks different. Yeah. He was looking the same at a couple of minutes ago. Am I right or not? All right. You guys keep fighting here. No problemo. Everything bueno. Go, guys. Go. Get mounted on this Mumai kills. We need more Mumai kills, ladies and gentlemen. But never mind. We have only the chance to recruit three of them. Am I right? Yeah. They are limited. So you can't have more than three of them at the same time. That's unfortunately not possible. I wanted to actually make like a huge army of Mumakias, but I believe they realize, I mean, let's be real, guys, mods are not balanced. Like, I've not seen a single mod which is balanced, you know? They are mainly for single player purposes and just to have fun, experiment with different styles of units which are normally not existing in Battle for Middle-earth games. But the truth is, the more units you add into a game, the harder it's going to be to balance in long terms. Again, great for... Oh, look at this. Theoden. Oh, he was spawning some shenanigans. Let's bail. Witch King is actually getting killed. No man can kill you, but you are all about to be dead, my friend. Okay, we need only one more power point, and that's going to unlock so many additional new units to us. Drummer Troll has the same leadership, just like in the normal battle for Middle-earth. Nothing has changed about that. Let's revive the hero we have lost before. And I wanna test those Mumai kills now. You know, I wanna test them now. Okay, just keep spamming more orcs in the meantime. The orc pits are level 3. That means they will be having more production speed on the orc pits. Remember, every upgrade, every level in Battle for Middle-earth 1 matters a lot. And you cannot buy the upgrade for a structure, unlike you can in Battle for Middle-earth 2 and Rise of the Witch King. Here, you need to recruit units to be able to, you know, get it to level 2 / level 3. But once you are level 3, you will get 50% faster build speed. That means by the time you get only one orc, you will get two orcs. I was good in math, by the way. 12 power points collected, ladies and gents. Oh, no, I'm blind. It's 18 what we need, not 12. Okay, actually, it's a lot. Like, again, not balanced, you know? It's just for fun, I guess. This Haradrim's on top of the Mumai kill, though, they are hitting like a truck. I like that. Our heroes are also healing up slowly but surely over time. That's also not bad. This is giving them more damage and less armor. The wedge formation, we are used to that normally. Let's take it down. Elma, the horse of Rohan, is running for his life. We have seen him in the last video. And now what I would love to do is, you know, kind of limit testing. I want to see how tanky and how beefy those Mumai kills are. And also, I want to find out if the darkness is affects them, because it, you know, it affects them in normal battle for middle of one. And if this is affecting them, you know, this one actually doesn't give you any armor, and armor is essential. But I believe with 100% more damage output from the Mumai kills, they will eventually end up one-shotting the parts of the wall from... Look at this. Arrow animation. I mean, the arrows are dealing zero damage to the structures, by the way. The Mumai kills are going to war, ladies and gentlemen. Let's surround. I also like the design of them. They look pretty nice. I mean, they are such a unique unit. And I was... Oh, Elma, what are you doing, my friend? Elma, you will die. I mean, you don't even... I don't even need to trample you, right? I don't even need to trample you, my friend. Okay. I will break him. So, after killing everything what he got, I want to make a... such a big orc army, like never seen before. And then we just go inside the genes, you know, all together. Let's get them all banner. That's gonna break our bank, but it's fine. We are just breaking the parts of the wall one by one. And the Mumai kills, you can see and tell, they are way tankier in this mod. Way, way tankier in this mod. So where are our trolls at? Drummer trolls. You guys, hold on a second. Trolls, you go ham. He has so many rams inside the genes. Holy moly. You guys know what I'm planning to do, right? Okay, now we have almost the power points we need. Come on, the Dark Tower. I need it now. Come on now, just kill the rams. We will make this Rohan castle look like a Mordor slash Isengard castle. Boom, finally. It's a passive thing. Doesn't change anything here. What is that? Dark Tower. Upgrades the Tita into a Dark Tower. Allows elite Easterlings and Morgul orcs to be built. Summons Nazgul. And only one might maybe build at the same time. So we can build it here too, right? No. Okay, I mean, he has literally nothing that can kill our Mumai kills, I guess. They are like immune to damage from the normal towers too. Okay. I mean, also trolls are kind of beefy. Or Rohan is just too weak. I don't know what it is. Like, our Mumai kills can literally not die. Okay, just protect this area, I guess. Don't die. I mean, just die. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay, let's go back then. Because you can't be killed. I believe they have not the strength to actually take down our trolls anytime soon. Our Mumai kills are also extremely tanky. But now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the chance to also recruit archers of Rune. As well as... which one was it, actually? Like, I believe these, right? Archers of Morgul. I want to see them also. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I want to see them also. Let's recruit two of them. And also Orcs of Morgul. I want to see them. They also cost 200 each. So now let's stop making normal Orcs and make more Orcs of Morgul. Since they are unique to this mod, right? Okay, let's keep breaking the parts of the wall. It's almost there. It's almost looking like a Mordor... I mean, I believe they... I don't know why they did this, by the way. That doesn't make any sense. Why would you make the postern gate so the units are not able to enter or exit the horses? And if you do such a change, I believe you also need to modify the AI. Because once again, the mods are mainly, but not exclusively, being made for single-player experience. And if the player is playing a single-player game against a Rohan, who will obviously close the gate as it's a hard army, and they have no way of exiting the gate, exiting the base again, because they have no clue that they are not able to use the postern gate, it's going to kind of destroy the fan factor, and you are literally not able to play against good factions anymore, you know? That's what I'm trying to say. Alright. Okay, it's almost there, boys. Almost there. He's repairing the gate, by the way. Okay, these are orcs. The Day of Orcs. Where are the... Oh, look at them, boys. The Archers of Morgul. I want to see how they are looking like. That's how they are looking like. They look like... Yeah, they look like runes a little bit, right? Look at the mask from this dude. Looks pretty funny. They have also the skirmish formation for more DPS and less armor, much less armor, but also the banner plus, you know, heavy armor, no heavy armor, fire arrow. Heavy armor is unfortunately not existing. Also, black orcs, they have nothing, no forge blades, they have only the possibility to get banners. But that's pretty much it. Money is looking good, we have 6 power points collected. And now we can pick up this one to get even more money from the structures. Now every structure, also movement kill pen slash... Troll cage is going to give us money, if I'm not mistaken, right? Yeah, should be like that. It means every production building which you are normally using to recruit units will turn into resource buildings, long story short. Okay, they've all nice. Hold on. Okay, so only one part of the wall is remaining, or two parts of the wall. I was lying, actually. Let's kill them all, and then, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to send all these orcs to the war. And we have actually a Nazgul now on the Fel Beast, and I believe that comes from the tower. I like this tower design too from Mordor. Looks pretty nice to me, right? Right? It doesn't look bad, actually, the smaller tower. The Nazgul has the 9 servants of Sauron, has more Nazgul scattered. I mean, he's a flyer. Also, leadership plus this. Minus 10% damage, minus 10% combat experience, and fear resistance to nearby enemy. It's a debuff. Long story short. That's how the Mordor base is looking like, ladies and gentlemen. Rohan base is looking like. I was confused for a second because the base is literally looking like from Mordor. Okay, so orcs, you guys are going to war, okay? No, not trolls. Hold on. Oh, please? Okay, so you guys and you guys plus the heroes, okay? So, you guys go all here. I want to see that. I want to see that with Darkness, Eye of Sauron. I want to see the maximum leadership possibility and how this is going to look like. I would love to see that. And again, if you want to, where are the Haradrim marches actually? But we are command points kept, are we not? We are. Let's actually, I would like to see them. Hold on a second, because I haven't seen them yet. Okay, these are Arches of Rune. Okay, we have seen them already. They have not even the chance to get actually fire arrows. I believe they are literally worse than the Haradrim skirmishers, I believe. But I don't know about their DPS though. But again, they have to deal kind of great amount of damage. Witch King is here. Oh, he's level 10. That's the animation. Yeah, that's the animation. Let's get dismounted. As I would like to see also toggle weapon. And I want to see. Look, he has now like a flaming sword. Like a budget Anduril sword, you know? But he's also moonwalking a little bit. Come on, Witch King, attack. Is he even able to attack? Yes. He's attacking way slower, but the real picture what I want to show you guys is this. With Dramatrol being around, and leadership is going crazy. Like, leadership is going crazy. Just go all here, guys. We have so many of them, and more of them are coming. 800 command points is a little bit too much. Our goal in the patch 2.2 was also to increase the command points to a decent amount, but 800 is just too much. Imagine a multiplayer game in which you are playing Eol against Evil, and you are both able to recruit up to 800 command points full of units that you would not be able to play anymore. And I also see some of you guys also asking in the comment section down below, Shanks, is it possible to increase the speed FPS to 60? Yes, it is possible, but it doesn't make any sense. We tried. It's just not playable anymore. It looks so funny, guys, by the way, if you have not seen this before. Anyways. Oh, maybe I was celebrating a little bit too early. Because I believe he has the outpost here around this side. And even a... okay. I like the debuff, though. Minus 10% damage, and I don't know about the minus 50% fear resistant. How is this possible? Like, is it gonna be like a gamble situation? They have 50% fear resistance, because I didn't think about fear resistance this way, to be honest with you guys. But I might be wrong. Anyways, our heroes are highly leveled. They are only missing the black now. They have it. Okay. Yeah, you see like a black smoke kind of thing to debuff the enemy units, which is like an active thing, and which is also reloading kind of fastish. It's a huge debuff, by the way. They make them lose more than a quarter of their armor and half of their damage output. That's kind of nuts. Anyways, we are surrounding him now with the forces of Mordor. And the last speech is, of course, from Saruman against the power of Mordor. There can be no victory. And with the voice of the Witch King, subscribe now. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.